This is John Cola with growingyourgreens.com. Today we're at the Maker Fair here in San Mateo, California. It's all about do-it-yourself inventors and people that make things. So I'm really excited to be here and to check it out and to see if there's anything having to do with gardening here at the Maker's Fair. So let's come inside and check it out. All right, so here's an excellent way to grow your own food in your house if you don't have a yard like I did to convert into all raised beds. You can grow it in an apartment in the middle of New York City. Even if you live in a trailer, you could grow this in your RV, Kevin, if you're watching my show. But this is algae. You can grow your own spirulina wherever you are. And all you need pretty much is like an aquarium, and this is it. And you need a good kit, like from algaelab.org. They're gonna explain the process. They teach classes. They'll teach you how to do this stuff. So we're here with Aaron today. He's from algaelab.org, and he's gonna show us how to harvest the spirulina.
That's right. So one window growing spirulina can supply enough to transform the diet of a person. It's very easy to harvest. Basically, you have down here your live spirulina, and you're gonna siphon it through here. Through this cloth, it's over here. This cloth has 40 micron openings. It's screen printing fabric, and it'll catch the spirulina, and then the water will go through and put the water back in. And spirulina is actually very water. It uses very little water to grow because you recycle the water. And then you're going to have a live, fresh superfood. You cannot buy live, fresh spirulina. You can only get the powdered stuff, and it's extremely sensitive to the drying process, so you have much better nutrition from the live stuff. And as you can watch it here, and you can see the green area growing, that's live spirulina getting caught on the cloth. And you'll see it getting denser and getting bigger. Yeah, we're just gonna get a little bit. Normally I'd filter out about a quarter of the tank, and that would give us a good tablespoon or so of live spirulina. And you can do that about every other day with a tank this size. And then you just squeeze out the remaining water. Just kind of gather it up. And squeeze out that last bit. Because that's very, very alkaline. One of the things about spirulina is it's an extremophile. It grows in extremely high alkaline environments, which means that nothing else will grow with the spirulina because the alkalinity is so high. And then when you've harvested, you get this. Live spirulina has almost no taste to it, and it's got a nice creamy texture, and is extremely healthful. And that's basically all it takes. You just pour the liquid back. Day after day after day, because spirulina grows very quickly. It's like a pet or a house plant, except that it feeds you every day.
All right, so I think this is the first time ever I've had fresh, live spirulina. I often eat the powder, but this is cool that you can do this fresh, and watch for a future episode where I will be growing my own spirulina one of these days.
Right.
So all you do is you just take this little toothpick here and scrape some off on the toothpick, and wow, man, that's good stuff. Nice, really creamy texture, and I can just imagine adding that to like a banana fruit smoothie. It's gonna be so good, and I can't wait to grow spirulina. So everybody out there, don't, you know, say, I can't grow anything, I live in an apartment. You can grow spirulina. So we're here at the General Hydroponics booth here at the Maker's Fair, and they're demonstrating how easy it is to grow hydroponically, and here's a really easy setup. All they're really doing is using Coke bottles, and that seems to be a nice theme here at the Maker's Festival, to Maker's Fair, to basically they cut the Coke bottle in half, they glued in some tube on the bottom, and that's the return line, and on the top they have a tube that's basically feeding water to it. They got some hydroton ceramic ball things in there, and some medium, and this is not soil, and the tomatoes. And so you gotta make sure you have a good nutrient solution in there to allow it to grow. And you can see the line, the return line comes into this little bucket. It's about a 1 gallon or 2 gallon bucket. And you can see they just have a simple pump in there. And that basically the return line's in the bottom and the pump pumps up the water into the hose and goes into each of the bottles, into the cut down Coke bottles. And that's how easy it is to grow hydroponically. Now this is just a demonstration system, and I don't know if this would work on a real big scale, but if you're screwing around, you could do something like this. But
so if you're really serious about growing hydroponically, you should get the General Hydroponics water farm. It comes with 8 different, basically 5-gallon buckets to grow your own food hydroponically. Now this system's gonna set you back approximately $500, so you know it's not cheap. Definitely a lot easier to grow in soil, but there's many advantages to growing hydroponically. All right, so General Hydroponics now has a new line. It's called General Organics for the home gardener to use in their to grow plants outside. And it's really cool, such as this one here, BioThrive. It's a vegan plant food in a bottle. BioThrive, another one, plant food. This is called Bloom. This one's called Grow. They have Bio Root Booster. They even have something I really like, Bio Weed, which is a cold processed seaweed. So basically this is a raw food for your plants now. So one of the cooler products here, you know, and I get the question a lot, John, what do you do about the bugs? Well, now I could use Azomax for all my bugs. This is an insecticide that's basically OMRI listed for use in organic gardening. Basically what it is, it's basically extracted from neem oil. So you could use neem oil, which has the same properties as this, but this is more of a concentrated version, which may actually work better. We're here at the Maker's Fair, and we're at the Master Gardener's booth here for San Mateo and San Francisco County. And they have this cool strawberry tower that you can make. So this is a great way to save space, grow lots of strawberries with 2 5-gallon buckets. Yet another use of buckets that I didn't talk about before. And so this is great. Here's the instructions here. But if you're not here to see the instructions, you could actually download the instructions at groups.ucanr.org/San Mateo to download your own instructions on how to build your own and plant a strawberry tower made out of waste 5-gallon buckets and a whole bunch of strawberry plants. And it looks like they have, you know, several dozen strawberry plants in here, and I'm sure it's gonna yield quite well. So check out the Master Gardeners in your area for hints and tips and for instruction on how to help you to grow your own foods at your house. Have you ever wondered what you could do with your old window shade? Well, you know, I have lots of plants in my garden that actually don't have tags. So an old window shade is the perfect material to make plant tags. All you have to do is grab a scissors and literally cut it out, and then right on there, you know, let's see, I'm growing carrots. So we're gonna put carrots, real simple, and then you can just stick it in your planter, and there you go. Easy plant tag, everybody should do it. I know y'all got extra window blinds out there, and label your plants, especially the varieties. If you're growing many varieties, you can get confused sometimes. Great thing to do with your old window blinds, and you can do ones with the metal as well. And what I use instead of the blinds, actually, I go out and buy roof flashing, aluminum roof flashing, that works as well. You can cut that up if you don't have your window blinds. Now we're gonna talk about worm composting. Another booth here at the Maker's Fair has you know, composting, regular composting, also worm composting. So you could buy something like this. It's called the Wiggly Ranch, and this is to keep your worms, and this is approximately $100, and they have other ones that will hold your worms as well. It basically is a nice design. It just comes off, and the worms go in here. You put your food scraps in here, and you fill them up at the bottom first, and the worm pee, actually, you can collect with this little spigot in a jar. That's really good for your garden. And as the worms finish off, you keep only putting the produce in on the top, and they move their way up, and then so then you can take off the bottom trays when it's finished. And this system is about $100, but if you want to do it the low tech method, you can just go to your local Walmart or big box store and buy some of these roughneck Rubbermaid containers, or even other similar containers. And basically you just gotta punch a whole bunch of holes in it for air circulation. And there's also some holes in the bottom there because the worm pee needs to drain out somewhere. And then you simply nest this one into another one so that the worm pee could drain out in there. It's really neat and easy. And then basically you can see we're gonna go ahead and you just put your food scraps in here. And if you do it right, it's not gonna smell and not gonna stink. You definitely wanna keep it in a nice area that stays pretty stable temperature, not outside in the hot sun and, you know, not freezing. But you can see here's all the stuff, all the different things. You could put newspaper scraps if your mixture's too wet.
and different food scraps, and you'll see all the different worms in here. Let's go ahead and use the hands, see if we can find some worms in here. And it's gonna compost faster with more worms and less fast with less worms. There's little worms all in there. They're gonna eat all this stuff up in about a month. Here, this will be turned into rich compost. Worm castings is probably one of the best things you could put in your garden. So you can do this at home. You can check online for a lot of different instructions on how to do your own worm box at home, in your kitchen, or even outside.
So I hope you enjoyed seeing my clips here from the Maker's Fair. It's getting late, and they're gonna be some cool sculptures and so many other things to see here at the Maker's Fair. We got a big train going here. It's taking off, and I think it's time for me to take off too. So this is John Cola with GrowingYourGreens.com. We'll see you next time.